if it was dinner, fair enough, because then you're supposed to go. Random.
Really?
No?
Not really.
Oh, no.
But if you're going to tend to put some short stuff across.
It was under it to light the new stuff that was going in. Yeah. So it probably could have done with the tube out last night.
No one wants to be eating foil.
300 grams of oats.
300? Oh, so you're putting more wet.
Yeah.
And then
it's over in Oxfordshire somewhere, it's about 50-odd mile away.
So this is raw butter, isn't it, you're using?
All raw butter.
From a local raw dairy then?
Local raw dairy, just up in North Crawley. They do milk, butter, fresh yoghurt, you know. Obviously they do veal as well. Fantastic meat.
Just about managed it.
I can't, the trouble is if I'm doing it, I'm doing stuff.
That one there, yeah.
So I've done their bread there.
So you reckon, these are deer tracks?
Yeah, that, yeah.
You can just see the hoof marks there from the hoof going in. And again, this is a deer track coming the opposite direction. And it's splayed out a bit more as it's coming over.
That you'll get ID from.
So this is ash, we're just doing a bit of ID now. So can you tell it was ash again? This water, the black buds?
These yeah? Black buds here, this time of year. And then elder that you're asking about is here, look, that's elder.
No, come here. Really easy way to tell this is if I can break it.
See, it's got that really hollow pith.
Right.
That big, no, it's all soft and spongy in there. So it's a very hollow.
Gotcha.
Wood. Yeah, that's elder. This is another dead bit, I think. Oh no, it's not. Yeah, that's dead. You can see again, nice and hollow. So you can burn that out really easily.
Right.
You want to make, well, I don't know, what you'd use it for, straws, pipes, whatever.
Interesting. So when you say burn it out, what? How would you go about?
Just heat up a skewer or something,
and just kind of poke it through the middle.
Yeah. Get a skewer nice and hot, because it's a very kind of fibrous stuff inside. I don't know what it is. It is the pith of the wood, but it's very, very kind of porous and fibrous, and much softer than the wood itself.
Animals will always take the easiest route to places. Always.
The little one over the other side of the woods on the other end.
So what we're looking at here is some badger sets. So we've just got a very deep one. Let's be very careful, don't upset.
No, where I used to.
Very, very deep badger set there. Just one over here. Just kind of next to the stream. A badger set just there as well.
It's quite scary actually when you first find one.
So here we're looking at some badger tracks, aren't we?
Yeah. You can just tell here, you've got the back of the pad, which effectively is the heel of the pad, just in here. Mm-hmm. And then you can just see here, but roughly about the size of my little finger, sort of the toes with the claw imprints on the front edge where he's obviously dug in as he's going down. You can just see here as well, you've got some tiny indentations from some smaller animals as well, because you know there's a fair few animals that use obviously pathways and stuff round here. If I clear it out, you can just see two little claw marks and tiny little pads, you know. So it's quite a well.
And from
used.
Here they just work their way up here and then also to the tracks, aren't they?
Yeah, it's quite a well used thoroughfare down there.
From here we're just on the other side of the stream, you can see how deep that badger set goes. Well, it's a bit difficult to see in the lighting. They go very, very deep. Here's another badger track, just goes inside there. Difficult to see. It just kind of goes through. Yeah. So it's very difficult to see on this camera.
You're gonna get a bit of photo in there. Right on the tip of the branch, look at that.
You can see that movement.
Don't stay still very long.
And what was that again? That's a woodpecker.
It's a blue tip.
It's a blue tip. And I'll tell you what, he was picking, I just learned something new today. So he was picking stuff off the branch, but you're saying it was digging for.
There's probably a little insect under that, and that just literally fluttered down on the wind towards us, and I managed to catch it. So just a little bit of lichen that's growing on the branch of that ash tree there. Actually, it's an oak.
You should get a job with an English cricket team catching like that, man. Seriously. It's weird. Like, we were just talking, literally looking at it, it's pecking away, and it flew off straight into Lee's hand. It's mad. So you're saying to pick away just to kind of, what, get to the bugs and stuff?
Yeah, there's probably a little insect hiding underneath it. So he's pecking away looking for food, basically. Nice and sunny. So they're out and they're active today.
Look at that. Years ago, when I said bird watching, I'd be looking out for women in the local town centre.
Yeah.
Now it's a different kind of bird watching.
Well,
your best play.
So guys, it's Zed from Zedoutdoors. Look at that, I'm doing a late intro. Better late than never, huh? So I'm actually at my friend Lee's, who's seen in previous videos, at his woodland. I was spending a day doing some woodland management. So this is some ash that they processed. This is all basically decayed. This is a decayed ash tree that they've been kind of limbing off. And I believe it's this one here. See right at the top here, it's difficult to see, but it's a decaying tree, so they've had to, for safety reasons, kind of process it up. So you can see the tools here. So they were here yesterday, and I came down today with my nephew. So yeah, Lee's got his kids, the other guys have got their kids, so the kids can have a day out kind of playing around. It's just a very relaxed couple of days. You know, Lee's been here and the other guys have been here since yesterday. I was only able to come down today in the morning, so I'm leaving in the afternoon as with everyone else. And that's what we do, man. Do days of woodland management, bit of charcoal making, and a few bits and bobs.
Have you seen?
Hot in a bodice.
Drop their gorgeous, but she's not actually that pretty.
She is.
Well, we've been trying to speak to Chris about his smoking habit.
She'd look pretty.
Trying to smoke in front of his stones ain't good for you.
So I was talking about Chris and Stuart in a bodice.
I love these things, man.
She does look good in a bodice.
Or did she put the brush?
Soup. I made it especially for you because it's spicy.
Yeah.
So the ash that was all kind of trimmed down with the chainsaw has all been sorted out into different sizes. So obviously that's been sorted out into there. This is the piece here. That's all been kind of taken from. A lot of the guys are going to be taking the larger pieces for carving. For the ash carving. This is the tree it's actually come from. And this is all kind of like X marks the spot. As you can see here, it's all rotten out. Oh, from the inside, it's actually very dangerous. It would decay, so that's why it had to be kind of fell down.
Can we put your jumper on to keep?
Hey, let's get as adults, we've got to have a recreational moment. There we go. So we just strung up a tire.
Back here, please.
Do you want me to stretch it in a bit?
I'll
just put your hand in your leg then.
How did you go find the
strap? Push me as high as you possibly can.
Right, you ready then?
Yeah.
Well, she doesn't want to
look. Stand back, mate. How as you really possibly can?
What if it breaks?
I don't care!
Kind of end on.
So here we're looking at friend Chris's handle job. Look at that. So what is it you've done here, Chris, then?
This handle's been rattling around in my tool basket and needed a recarve. So I had plain fresh sycamore and decided to do a little bit of practicing on the corralsing. As I said, basically there's a spiral that starts here and goes all the way around, which was my starting point. And then just gone for this vine design, lots of curves, sort of trying out different little flowers and little fun things to do. So this bit here is my standard sort of spoon decoration.
Right.
So just a little nod towards that and a couple of flowers, a little signature, and just finish the end off with a little panel pin. Just,
and what did you use to stain it?
So this is coral zing, which is basically a slice, no wood's removed, it's literally just slicing through the fibres.
Right.
And then once I've completed the design, I take finely ground cinnamon.
Okay.
Which is a bark. Mm-hmm. Traditionally you would have had burnt alder root, coal, hence the coral zing name. And then just rub that into the patterns and the design. And then I oil over the top, and the oil soaks into the wood, it soaks through the cinnamon,
right.
And sets, and it locks it all in. Now, by using a knife not to remove timber, you're still having to slice through the grain.
Gotcha.
And it burrs, it compresses and raises a little bit.
Right.
So I then have to sand either 400, 600, whatever I've got to hand, and that just knocks down the surface and gives this nice smooth finish. And unusually for sanding I do with woodwork, like oil sand, so dip the sandpaper in a little bit of linseed and then just go over the top, and it just helps to fill in any gaps that haven't accepted, where there's any loose powder and things like that. And then this contraption is a scorp sheath that Lee developed. It hides the blade, so that's a spoon scorp XL, and keeps the blade well away from anything else. But as I said at the start, it rattles around in this tool bag. I think I lost the sheath off the saw and pulled it and wrecked an axe sheath and put another dink in this, so had to recarve it. And
beautiful work.
Yeah, got a long way to go from a carver's point of view. You know, there's little overruns, the transition sort of lines around the curves and stuff isn't perfect. Design wise, you know, it was just a sort of brain dump of lots of little things that I've wanted to try.
It's me.
So yeah, good bit of kit. And I think I'm going to go a bit further and decorate my handles on my other tools as well.
Go to town, why not?
That's it.
So you see something new every day. I've just seen Lee using this Super Jules.
This is why he's
got some. So what is it? This is literally what, for the purposes of just clamping?
Yeah, you can get various like jaw setups for it, or you can make your own that just bolt on. But the idea is you've got a lock button here, which is locked at the moment. So to unlock it, that's really solid in there at the moment.
Right.
If you just pull that lock switch up, tiny little bit of pressure, and it's off. Then you can slide that out. So these,
mixed up.
You can grip anything from an inch wide stick. And what you can do if you swap these around is you can slide that all the way off and actually turn it round.
Oh, to get much bigger.
So you can actually hold a door.
Oh, wow.
Is the idea. It held, I think, up to 900 mil, something like that. Clamping capacity.
What would be the purpose for it then, to clamp it? What,
just to hold things still. I mean, it's really useful if you want to buck long logs, like in this stack here, with a chainsaw. You can kind of clamp it in the middle and then just work a bit off of each end.
Right.
So if it's for firewood, park your wheelbarrow under it and just drop it straight.
So it's like another person there, basically.
Just something to hold your wood still. So I want to trim each end of this. So if I clamp it in the middle, a bit of pressure down to hold it, and then just flick the lock switch. It's rock solid. They're really quite stable. I mean, you could tip it over if you lift it up, but when you're pushing down on it, they're really stable from left to right.
Gotcha.
So yeah, useful bits of kit. Shorter, but just the angles weren't right. I was using this, I could actually hit the target with this.
So what is this, Leeson Ads, yeah?
Yeah, just so Hans Carlson.
Oh, it's beautiful, lads.
Just having a little play with it, it's nice. So we're just knocking the worst out of the middle of this before we're going to start with the gouge.
He's doing a cook set here, yeah?
That's the plan. We're just trying out the new timber that we haven't used for it before, which is willow. Might not work, but we don't know till we try.
It's a beautiful grain though, isn't it, where you're going into?
Yeah, well, this is where it's just started to spalt a little bit. So
you're using this for basically the roughing out of it?
Yeah, so you can only get really so deep with it in this small space, so we're just going to take out as much as we can. And then get onto the gouge work, which isn't far off really, because this is starting to bottom out now really in terms of being able to turn. I could creep out to the line a bit more, but until that is basically flat on that one,
so now you're doing the slightly more controlled, smoother work, aren't you?
That's it. So the gouge doesn't quite take as much out as quickly, but it's much more accurate. And just understanding the grain direction, working the four quadrants you would in a spoon, nice smooth cuts.
And that is a swan gouge by Nick Weston?
Yeah, so this is a swan neck with a single bend. And you see the plane of the tool's in the same plane as the handle.
Right.
And a dog leg's got a double bend,
gotcha.
So it kinks the tool round more, which allows you to get further down and in and lift the bottom piece up. I did get a very nice pass. Yeah, so that swan neck has done the middle in there, but once you get deeper, you can go in, but then the wall fouls the tool,
right.
And the blade angle then can't make a cut. But there's lots of moving around with cooks of work. So from this position, I can do the nose to sort of the side.
Worked.
So there's one of the guys who was annoying us in the team, so we decided to bury him. just don't tell anyone, right? No. What we've done here, do you want to just quickly talk through, Lee, while you're kind of...
Well, I'm certainly no expert. This is the second time I've ever even tried this.
So we're doing some charcoal making.
We're trying charcoal making in an oil drum. And it was bucketing down the rain yesterday, so I don't know how successful this is going to be, because we kind of had to abandon it for a little while. But hopefully we should have some charcoal in this barrel when we flip it back over. So we're just clearing that this soil that's around the edge has been used to basically seal it off when we shut the burn down.
Right.
So it starves it of air. So that basically the fire inside goes out and then the residual heat cooks the wood that's in the barrel.
Gotcha. Go for it.
So this should roll back into the hole that we dug it out of.
So you made a slit in the drum there, basically.
Yeah, you basically cut a sort of a letterbox opening in it. And then this stuff on the top, none of this will be charcoal, because these are the last bits to go in just to seal it off. And you can see any moisture that was left has kind of run down to the bottom.
Right.
They can go back onto the pile to start the next burn. And we might just have a load of dry sticks in this barrel because of the way it was going yesterday. But if we're lucky, we might have some charcoal right in the middle. I think it's starting to get a bit of flake there, but it'll be right in the middle if there is any. By the looks of it, we might have abandoned it for too long in the rain. I think we have.
Not doing good, mate.
Either that or we didn't pack it tight enough.
So the principle is you're basically starving of oxygen.
Yeah,
you're drawing out all the...
Start by lighting a fire in the bottom of the barrel. And then you're packing it with green wood.
Right.
And the object of the game is to burn the wood to the point where you've driven all the moisture out of it, but not taken all of the calorific value out of it. So you're making really quick, easy to light firewood, basically. And we might have a little bit right in the bottom, but it's going to be very slim pickings, I think. So, and it is a bit of an art form, to be honest. It takes years of practice, but this one's... Now, see, if it breaks, you can see that's just started to go. But if it was charcoal, it would be fairly easy to break.
Gotcha.
There you are. That looks a bit more promising.
Let's try that. No, it's still solid in the middle.
Still solid.
So yeah,
there's one bit.
There we go. There's one bit of charcoal there so far. So we've basically left it too long. But what this will mean, all these dry sticks will be really good for starting another burn.
Gotcha.
Hopefully. Next time when it's not raining, with a bit of luck.
So there you have it, my friends. This is the first time you've seen my face in this entire video. Can you believe that? I've left the torment until the end with this dodgy nose. So I hope you enjoyed this short video. The truth is I wasn't actually going to record this day out, but just last minute I bought the camera for, what the heck, record a little bit of segment here and there. So like I said, we didn't show anything in an incredible amount of detail. It was just to kind of give you an overview of the day spent out here. Like I said, the guys have spent 2 days here. This is the second day. I just joined them today. It's a very relaxed kind of atmosphere. This is my friend Lee's Woodland, and they're just doing some management, and they're kindly inviting me to come along. And just learn some stuff, help out and, just kind of chill out, learn some skills, which I've done. And it's been an incredible, incredible day out. It really has. As you've seen from the video, we've tried our hands at a few different things. And it's great. You're always picking up little nuggets of wisdom. The kids have had a great time out, screaming, shouting, swinging. That's what you do, right, when you're a kid. So it's been a really great day out. We've been blessed with beautiful sunshine, although it has been cold, as you can tell by all these layers that I'm wearing. So I hope you enjoyed this video. What I have done is taken a few photos of this day out as well, and I've posted them to my Facebook fan page. So if you want to check those out, feel free to do so by clicking the link just below this video, and that will take you over to my fan page. And there's an album of photos that I've taken that you can see stuff in a lot more kind of detail. Also, a little heads up that I showed obviously Lee Stoffer. A lot of you will be familiar with him if you've been following my channel for any length of time. I'm going to put a link to his YouTube channel below, and also my friend Chris. Lee Stoffer, if you're not already subscribed to his channel, please do go check it out. He's posted up some great videos. They're both extremely highly skilled greenwood workers. Very, very talented guys. They're very nice guys as well. Very giving in terms of their knowledge. So I'm going to put a link to Lee Stoffer's channel below. Please head over, subscribe to his channel and check out his content. Also, my friend Chris, who I've met through Lee. I've known Chris for a while now. Another very, very talented guy. We finally convinced him to join the dark side here on YouTube. So he's just set up his own channel, and he's going to start putting out videos as well. And he's a very, very knowledgeable guy with a great demeanor. And if I could ask you to go and click the link below to go and check out Chris's channel as well. And then, like I said, hit the subscribe button. He will be putting out a lot of videos as of the point of me putting out this video. So there you go. The link below to the Facebook fan page for a collection of photos. Links below to both Lee Stoffer and Chris Allen's YouTube channels respectively. Please go over, head over, hit the subscribe button. Like I said, you won't be kind of disappointed with the content they are sharing and will be sharing. And I hope you enjoyed this short video. Like I said, I apologize for the kind of patchy footage. Just trying to capture as much as I can, because my focus is obviously to be here and learn. So I'm just using this kind of opportunity, kind of given permission by the guys, to pull out this camera and record a few little snippets here and there to record a bit of a highlight of the entire day. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're not subscribed to my channel already, why not? Why not? Why don't you subscribe to my channel? I'm joking. You can see the logo somewhere on the screen. And like I say, if you click on that, it'll allow you to subscribe to my channel. And you'll be able to see a lot more videos pulling out in the future. You can see the backlog of videos that I've already done. So like I said, check out the links below this video. I hope you enjoyed this short video that you've just seen right now. And I hope whatever you're doing, as always, you have a blessed day, a blessed week ahead. This is Ed from Zed Outdoors. Peace out.